Have you ever felt like you're paying too much for your automation tools? Or maybe you're needing to customize them but can't? This video will show you three ways to install self-hosted n8n so you can run automations on your own terms. Watch to the end and I'll show you how to quickly and easily install the highly scalable queue mode version of n8n, which you can scale up or down depending on your workflow needs. Now, before we jump in, if you're thinking self-hosting feels like a hassle, that's okay, because n8n's cloud service is a great alternative. They handle the setup and management, letting you focus on creating and running automation workflows. Using the sign-up link in the description gives you a free trial and helps support this channel. But otherwise, if you love having full control, let's get right into self-hosting. Benefits of self-hosting. Here's a quick two-point summary of why you might want to host your own instance of n8n. Unlimited automations. You can run as many workflows as you want. No limits, no hidden costs. Full customization. Add community-built nodes or write your own custom code in Python or JavaScript. I go into a lot more detail about the pros and cons of self-hosting n8n and extending its functionality in a previous video, which you can watch up here. System requirements. Good news, n8n doesn't need a lot to run. Here are the basics. For the database, you only need about 0.5 gig to 4 gigabytes of SSD storage. The memory requires 0.3 gigabytes to 2 gigabytes of RAM, not very much at all. And for the CPU, it says minimum 10 CPU cycles, scaling as needed. And here it says n8n isn't CPU intensive, so even small instances should be enough for most use cases. And priority should be given to the memory instead of the CPU. If your workflows get really complex, like dealing with custom code or big files, you might need a bit more power. But for most workflows, small servers should be just fine. Installing n8n. The first two methods that I'm going to talk about, you can run on your local computer for free. That's either Windows, Mac, or Linux. Or you can run it on any server of your choosing. So the first method of installing is through NPM, or Node Package Manager. This method requires 4 steps. Step 1 is to install Node.js 18 or higher, and you can download and install that on the Node.js website. And here you can see on the download page, the latest LTS version is 20.17. And you just select the operating system that you're installing it on, and you would download it and install it onto your computer. Step 2 is to open up your terminal if you're on a Mac, and to do that you would hit Command Spacebar and start typing in terminal and hit enter, and that'll open up a terminal window for you. And if you're on a PC, you would open up your command prompt, and to do that you would hit the Windows key and S and type in CMD and then press enter. Then, step 3 is to type in npm install -g n8n for the most current production release, or add at next for the latest beta version, and then press enter. And then the last step is to run n8n by typing n8n. Done. You're good to go. When it comes to updating n8n, if you look at the bottom of the left navigation bar, you may see an update notice showing you that a new version is available. And if you click on that update, it does give you a message where it tells you what version that you're on and how long ago it was released and what the latest and greatest version is. To update to this latest version, type the following into the terminal window: npm update -g n8n. And that's for the latest production version. Or again, you can add at latest at the end if you want to update to the latest beta version. N8n installation method number 2. Docker. Reasons to use Docker over npm? Here are some advantages. It installs n8n in a clean environment. It's easier to set up if you want to use Postgres instead of the default SQLite. And you can avoid issues due to different operating systems, as Docker provides a consistent system. Now, a downside to using Docker is that it typically takes up more storage space on your system, since it runs a container with its own operating system and software, separate from your base operating system. While I personally like the NPM install over Docker, if you have problems installing via NPM, or if you want to keep n8n separate from your main system, you might want to use the Docker method. And there's three steps. The first step is to install Docker Desktop from the Docker website. And you can see here right on their homepage, they have a button here that says download for Mac. But if you drop this down, there are other options for Windows and Linux as well. Once you download the app, you would install it onto your computer. Step two is to create a volume to store your data. And you would do this by going back to your terminal or command prompt if you're on Windows, and you would type the following: Docker volume create n8n underscore data. And it's actually here, and I can just copy and paste it into my terminal window. Step three is to run this command to start n8n. And it's this long string here. Copy it to your clipboard, paste it into terminal, and it'll do everything it needs to do to set up its own Docker container. And then if I go to localhost port 5678, you can see here a new instance of n8n is set up. Now, when it comes to updating n8n from Docker Desktop, navigate to the Images tab and select the Pull tab from this three dots drop down. And once you select Pull, it'll update to the latest n8n image. Now, the third method of installing n8n is through server setups. Want something more permanent and scalable? Hosting on a server is the way to go. n8n can be hosted on almost any kind of server. As you can see here, there's a lot of different ways that n8n can be hosted. One noteworthy option of server hosting n8n is through a DigitalOcean droplet. And you can follow the instructions on this page to have n8n up and running with just a few clicks through DigitalOcean. Full guides for all of these methods are in the n8n docs. But here's the good part. I'm going to show you how to set up the best, most scalable version of n8n called Q-Mode. Why Q-Mode? It's n8n's top choice for scalability and performance. Here's how it works. The main instance receives the workflow info, either through a time-based trigger or webhook calls, etc. Then one or more worker instances executes these workflows. Redis, which is a fast in-memory database, sits in the middle and handles the tasks quickly. It actually sends messages to and from the main instance and the workers. And of course, there's the main n8n database, which drives everything. Optionally, you can also add a webhook processor, which allows you to scale the incoming webhook requests for further performance improvements. Now, setting up Q-Mode manually can be tricky, but with a service called Railway, it's simple. They offer templates that handle most of the heavy lifting. As you can see with this template, there's the primary node, which is the main instance, a worker node, a Redis messaging node, as well as the Postgres database. And with this template, everything is the same as the last one, except they add in a webhook processor node. So here's how to install the Q-Mode version of n8n on Railway. The first step is to use the link in the description to go to railway.app. Railway gives me a little bit of server credit, but it doesn't cost you anything extra. The hobby plan is all you need to get the Q-Mode version of n8n up and running, which is $5 per month plus resource usage. You can see that what's included is well beyond the system requirements needed to run a basic version of n8n, and it's well worth it, in my opinion, for the highly performant version of n8n you get. Step two is to choose the Q-Mode template or Q-Mode with webhook processors template. Links to both these templates are in the description. And the last step is to click the Deploy Now button. You can see here this template deploys 5 services, and you have the opportunity to configure each one if you like, but I'm going to leave it as the default, and I'm going to click Deploy. So give it some time to install all those services. You may need to refresh your browser to see the installed instance. So in order to access this instance of n8n, you would go to the main instance here, click on it, and you would go to Settings here, scroll down to Public Networking, and it says here, access your application over HTTP with the following domains. So this is the default domain, and if I copy this and go to a new tab and paste it, you can see there is this full version of n8n running. But I can also add a custom domain. So any domain that I own, I can add it through my DNS server first and then add it here. And then I can access this n8n instance through that domain name. And that's it. You now have a production grade version of n8n in their performant and scalable queue mode running 24/7 for about $5 per month and ready to scale up if you need to. Now, I do need to mention that these n8n templates are not official releases by n8n. They are community driven and they are contributed by users. So in this case, this template was contributed by a user named Jack. You can see that there's a lot of people that have active projects using this template, and there's 100% success on recent deploys. And there is a discussion board here that you can click on if you have any problems or you need to troubleshoot at all. Now, if you see this n8n login screen, congratulations. You've successfully set up an instance of n8n. So to wrap it up, self-hosting n8n gives you unlimited customizable automations. We went over three installation methods: NPM, Docker, or server setups with Railway. Queue mode on Railway is my top pick for scalability and performance. If you're after cost savings, flexibility, and powerful workflows, n8n is a stellar choice, especially if you're okay with a bit of hands-on management. I'd love to hear which self-hosting method you prefer and what else you want to learn about n8n. Drop a comment below. Don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful, and check out my next video on getting started with n8n and adding community nodes. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.